I met Ken Freed in St. Paul, and we sort of happened on each other, and he said, "Hello, I'm conducting Mankato Symphony." And I was like, "What? You know, wow, that's amazing." And so the two of us actually started thinking of ways we could put together a program to deal with, you know, some of the events, obviously with Mankato and its history in 1862, and we've got the 150th coming up for, you know, 2012.
It's a very unique project in the sense of just trying to bring what, you know, Western classical music and the idea of a powwow, the event, bringing them together.
It's Maza Kute, and it's a name of one of our leaders back in the day. Maza Kute Manny. He's buried back in Santee, and he was at one time a pretty good warrior, I guess, and then later on became one of the first ordained Episcopal ministers. So that's kind of how we honored that name that way. That's how we got the name.
The original idea with all of this music was to try and create music that sort of intersects, you know, American Indian life and Dakota life too, and orchestra music, or, you know, Western European music, and kind of put them together. And introduce American Indian themes and ideas and history and culture to audiences who might not be familiar with it. And then also inviting Native people in to see what orchestras do. You know, that doesn't happen all the time either.
First of all, tremendous education. Way back in my background is the Taino Indian of the Caribbean in Puerto Rico. And, you know, it's been very, very, very watered down over the many generations. And to live in a place like Minnesota, where the Native American heritage is such a present thing, it's kind of a distant kinship that I feel with the people here. And now to be able to play Brent's music and try to do everything that I can to feel it and sell it and have people struck by it emotionally as I was when I started to play it, that's my job. It's been a wonderful ride.